Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I'm going to show you all the 10 cards that I created while using the December card kit by Simon Says Stamp. But first, let's take a quick look on the card kit. So in this kit, you will get a Tibitronics Beginner Light Kit, which is going to take you through the process of lighting up your cards. I'm going to do one example later on. You also get these candy cane stickers. They are nice and dimensional, as well as these paper stickers, also dimensional. You do get two envelopes, a bigger red one and a smaller white one. You get an adorable stamp set that can inspire you to create loads of cards, as well as these papers that are great and they have beautiful designs, and you can pretty much make way more cards than 10 with this card kit. So you also get one vellum paper and four different cardstocks. As always, I'm going to start by cutting out the cardstock in half and creating 8 cards. So here they are all together, and just because they are 8 and I want to create 10 cards for this series of videos, I'm going to add 2 more from my stash. So let's start with the first card, and for that I'm going to use the obvious, which is super easy to create. I'm going to use this beautiful design and just cut out a rectangle. So here is the beginner's light kit. You get 3 little LEDs along with a battery, and I am going to light up the houses. So with my craft knife, I'm going to cut out 3 different windows. In the lighting kit, you will get instructions on how to use everything included. And since this is a video for creating 10 different cards, and I don't have a lot of time to show you step by step how to use the kit, I'm just going to take you through super quickly. So here are the 3 windows that I have cut out. I'm going to use my pencil and mark where those windows are going to fall on my card base. For my card base, I'm using the red one. So now that I know where this is going to fall, I'm going to pick up the vellum, cut out a piece, and I'm going to cover the back of the windows. So this way you will be able to see the lighting coming through even more. So now I know exactly where all those LEDs should be, just behind each window. I have marked the areas on my card base. And now I need to create a little pocket for the battery. Now the top of the battery is the plus, while the bottom of the battery is the minus. So I am going to make sure that I mark this on my piece of paper here, so that this way I will not make a mistake. And I am placing this pocket of the battery just behind the Santa Claus, so when you press Santa Claus, then the lights are going to turn on. So now I am using the foil tape to create all those little lines. You should have 2 different lines, one for plus and one for minus, and there are plenty of videos explaining exactly how this is done. So I am going to through this very quickly. I'm going over the flap and back again. I'm going to cut out and place the battery in the middle. Now, one thing you should do is to use your bone folder and make sure that everything is nicely stuck down. And then I'm going to place all the little LEDs exactly where I have the markings, so you can see how it lights up. One tip that I can give you to help you work this out quickly is to press with your bone folder those LEDs down. This is going to help do the connection. Now I'm going to use some tape adhesive and secure the battery. And now I'm going to stick the patterned paper on top. Now I have doubled up on foam tape at the back, which is going to make sure that the flap on the battery is going to stay open until you press it down, so the lights will not turn on by mistake. And I'm using my Wink of Stella to finish off my card. So here is a closer look to the card, as well as a closer look to those windows when they light up. And now let's move on to the second card. Now I'm going to create a little scene, so for that I'm going to use for my sky this pattern paper, which is full of snowflakes, and I'm also going to cut out a snowbank. In this snowbank I am going to stamp the sentiment for my card. I'm using black ink by Simon Says Stamp, and I went with the saying that says Christmas wishes, which comes from the stamp set that is included in the kit. I'm going to stick that snowbank at the very bottom of my pattern paper, and then on top I'm going to use those stickers. So the idea is to have that mailbox on one side and all the little letter stickers coming out from that. Now this card kit is obviously sold out because it's really adorable, and I think that it's a great value for its money, and you can make so many more cards than just 10 that I'm going to show you today. So just because this is sold out, I am going to link you down below all the supplies that are included in that kit that you can buy separately. There is also a giveaway on my blog for this card kit, so in case you want to win this card kit, make sure to visit my blog and enter your details. Now I'm going to stick that panel with tape adhesive directly on my white card base, and my card is finished. For the third card, I am going to do some white embossing directly on top of my card base. So I'm going to pick up the sentiment that says Merry and Bright, and I'm also going to use some snowflakes that are included in the stamp set. I'm going to place them all around the sentiment, and then I'm going to stamp with Versamark ink and white emboss them. And you can see that I am using my Misty here to stamp everything. It gives me the ability to go quickly since I don't have to stamp each snowflake separately. And I can also go ahead and stamp once again since I show that I haven't stamped the sentiment quite nicely. So now I'm going to apply my embossing powder. For that I'm using the white one by Tonic Studios. And then I'm going to use my heat gun and melt all the powder. Now that my background on the card base is ready, I'm going to stamp the focal point. For that I'm going with this adorable Rudolph that comes in the stamp set. I'm stamping it with archival ink on watercolor paper because I am planning to use my Tombos. So this archival ink is going to be permanent, and it's not going to smudge or smear when I am coloring everything. So I am going to color everything here, and then I'm going to use my scissors and cut out the reindeer, leaving a white space all around. This is going to make him look as if it's an already made embellishment or a little sticker. And if you find it difficult to cut out images while leaving a white border all around, first use your pencil and pencil down where exactly you want to cut, and then it's going to be easier for you. So again, I have used my favorite dies by Lone Fawn to cut out those snowbanks, and I'm going to place them directly on my card base, making sure that I use some foam tape at the back, which is going to give some dimension. So now I'm going to add some foam tape at the back of my reindeer and place him on one of those snowbanks, and then I'm going to create a little snowy candy lot by using the candy canes included in the kit. And I just couldn't help myself, I had to stick everything down on this card, but you can go and stick only a few of them and keep some for later. You will see that I'm not only going to stick all the candy canes here, but I'm also going to stick the white dots as snowflakes, as well as the little candies falling from the top. And to finish off my card, I'm going to add some Nouveau glitter on top of his nose as well as on his collar. And my little card is ready. Now for this card, I am going for a very elegant gold and white card. So first of all, I am going to stamp with Versamark ink the three gifts as well as the banner that come in the stamp set. And now I'm going to apply my gold embossing powder. This is by Tonic Studios. And I'm going to use my heat gun to heat set everything. And once everything was melted, I'm going to go back again to my Misty, and I'm going to stamp the sentiment that was included in the kit. There are actually two different sentiments that fit perfectly the curve of that banner, but for this card, I went with the one that says Merry and Bright Greetings. So after stamping everything, I have used my scissors to cut out all the little elements, and as I was cutting them out, I made sure that I left a white border all around. And now I'm going to use some foam tape at the back and stick them directly on this piece of cardstock. Now, here is where I am cheating, actually, because I have used this gold cardstock from my stash. And the idea here is to have all those presents hanging from the top of the card. So I am using this gold thread, which I am going to secure. And then I'm going to stick the presents directly at the bottom of those threads. So as you can see, I am securing the threads at the back with just a piece of scotch tape, and at the front with a tiny little tape, so that it doesn't show when I stick the presents on top. Now I'm going to peel off the backing and stick them down. And my card is pretty much ready. I just need to do some finishing touches to add even more sparkle on my card. So I have used some foam tape at the back, and I have attached this panel on top of a white card base, and now I'm using my gold Nuvo drops to add some touches on the gifts. So you can see that I have added, I have colored gold all the little dots on the first present, and I'm also going to color in the ribbons. And then finally, I am going to add some sequins and spread them at the very top of my card. Now for this card, I'm going to use the Christmas tree as well as two of the presents, and I'm going to stamp them with Memento Tuxedo black ink. I'm doing so because I am planning to color everything with my Copic markers. And here is where I am coloring everything with my Copics. I'm not doing any fancy coloring here. I'm just using three different colors and making sure that the bottom of the tree is darker than the top. So once I have everything ready, I'm going to cut them out with my scissors. Also notice that I didn't bother to leave white the lights on the Christmas tree. After all, I am going to do something on top later on, so you won't be able to see that. So now I am going to decide the placement on my card base. For my card base, I'm using the red cardstock, and I am going to stamp the sentiment. Again, for the sentiment, I'm going with Christmas wishes, which I'm going to stamp with Versamark ink and white emboss it. This is a really simple design, and I believe that you can make so many of those cards just by changing up the different images that are included in the kit. So you just need to bring in the tree, the gifts, as well as the reindeer, and make different combinations. And now I am placing all of those elements on top of my card. I am using some foam tape at the back to add a little bit of dimension. And I have also doubled up on the last gift, so when I stick it on top, it pops up even more. Now I have cut out a strip of paper from this pattern paper that is full of strips, and I'm going to stick it on one side of the card, just to add a little bit of interest. And now all I have to do is to finish off the lights on the Christmas tree. So for that I am going with Nuvo drops, and I am adding white, but you can go ahead and use any color that you like. And just because I can't stay away from it, I am going to add some shine on the ribbons and the star by using my Wing of Stella glitter pen. Now for the sixth card, I decided to use this advent calendar pattern paper, and just because this is not going to fit as a whole on top of my card, I am going to cut it out and make sure that at least I have on top of my card number 25. So I'm going to use this panel, and I am going to stick it directly on top of my card base. Now this can be a card as it is, but just because I want to add a little bit of interest on all my cards, I'm going to use my craft knife and my ruler, and I'm going to create little windows on this pattern paper. So I'm going all around that top square, and I'm going and cutting out only three of those edges. And you can see that I can open it up. Now I'm going to score the other edge so that it folds nicely. And I'm also going to use a tiny circle punch. I'm going to punch out a little hole, which is going to create a slit for the finger. And this way I get the perfect advent calendar look. Now I went ahead and created three different windows, and I'm creating the slits now for the finger, but you can go ahead and add as many windows as you like. I am going to add some tape adhesive at the back, and now I am going to measure where exactly these windows are going to fall on my card base. So now I know exactly where to stamp the sentiments. For that I went with Christmas Wishes, but that was included in the kit because it's tiny enough to fit in those windows. And I have also looked through my stash to find other tiny little sentiments, such as greetings from all of us and blessings. And I have stamped everything with white ink. Now I need to get rid of all those pencil marks with my eraser, and then I'm going to stick this panel directly on top of my card base. And also Ginger wanted to say hello, so I am going to make sure that I am going to place it directly on top of the card base so that all those greetings can be seen through the windows. Also notice how all those windows open in a different direction. I think this is a very fun card. Now in this one kit 10 cards, I consider it a tradition to create at least one shaker card. So let's go for that shaker card now. I am trying to find out a circle that matches perfectly the curve on the banner. So I am going to cut out a hole out of this pattern paper with the stripes. And I am going to place some tape adhesive at the back and stick at the back the acetate. So I have a base for my shaker card. Now I am going to place some foam tape all around that hole. Make sure that it's nice and tight so nothing is going to fall out. And now I'm going to place inside my sequins. And for my shaker mix today, I decided to go with these stars. They are very iridescent and they pick up the colors from all around. I think they are really beautiful. So now I'm going to stick a panel on top. I'm adding a little bit of tape adhesive there. And I'm also going to add foam tape all around. And stick it directly off on top of my white card base here. Now this is the same pattern paper as the one that I have used for the back of my shaker window. So on this one I'm going to stamp the banner. I used Versamark ink to stamp the banner, apply white embossing powder and heat set it. So here it is ready to go. Now again I'm going to stamp one more time, but this time the sentiment inside. So I'm picking one of those sentiments that fit perfectly inside that curve. And again I'm going to use Versamark ink and white emboss the sentiment. So everything is now pretty much ready to assemble my card. As you can see, I have stamped also Rudolph and colored him this time with my Copic markers. And the banner is also ready, so I'm just going to add some foam tape at the back of the banner and Rudolph, and then I can assemble my card. And you can see how perfectly the banner fits at the bottom of my window. And to finish it off again, I'm going to add some gloss on Rudolph's nose. I'm also going to add some glitter on his collar, and my card is finished. In the kit there is this pattern paper with 6 different images that you can take advantage and create the 6 different cards out of them. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to use this one that has a little label with gifts on top. So I have just cut out a panel out of this green pattern paper. I'm going to stick it directly on top of the green cardstock. I like to have frames all around my cards. I think that they give a more finished look. So you can see that this pattern paper, I have cut it out to be slightly smaller than the standard card. And I'm also going to use this strip of paper, which is actually a leftover from the previous card. I'm going to stick it down on top of the green cardstock, just by using some foam tape. And then on top of that, I'm going to stick the label, again by using some foam tape at the back. So the card is pretty much finished. I decided not to stamp a sentiment on this one. You can stamp a sentiment on the inside of the card, or if you want to, you can stamp at the very bottom. Now I am using glossy accents and I'm going over those gifts just to make them more shiny and to give a more finished look on the card. Super quick and easy to make. And here is another pattern paper that gives you many square images to use, and you can create different cards out of them. So I'm going to show you a design that you can follow. I have cut out one of those square images. I am using some foam tape at the back, and I'm going to stick it on this strip of paper. And this strip of paper actually comes from the Shaker card that I have created previously. It's a leftover. So I'm going to use some ribbon and tie a bow at the top of that square. And this is going to bring everything together. Now I have a little element to stick on top of my card. So I have cut out a piece of patterned paper, and this is exactly the size of a standard card, that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to stick it directly on top, cut off the excess, and my card is pretty much finished. I am going to stick it directly on top of a card base. For that I used the pale blue cardstock. I'm going to stick it with tape adhesive. And to finish off my card and add some sparkle, I am using my Nuvo Glitter Drops, and I'm going with red over some of the red trees and with green over some of the green trees. And you can follow pretty much the same design and create different cards out of those little squares that were included in that pattern paper. And now let's move on to the last card. Out of this pattern paper, I have cut out a panel that is 4.25 by 5.5. I am sticking at the very bottom a strip of paper. This comes from that pattern paper that is full of strips. And now I'm going to place it on my Misti, and I'm going to stamp the sentiment. Now for the sentiment, I'm going with Merry and Bright from the stamp set. I'm going to stamp it with Versamark ink, just like I always do, and then white emboss it. Now, to add some sparkle on my card, I decided to use those snowflake sequins that I had in my stash, and I'm also going to add on top those brads by Tim Holtz. Now, if you don't have in your stash snowflakes or those brads, then you can just go ahead and stamp the snowflakes that are included in the stamp set and white emboss them. They will give you pretty much the same look. So I am poking a hole there. I'm going to place the brad through the snowflake and then through the paper. And then I'm going to secure everything at the back. And once my panel is ready, I'm going to stick it directly on top of my card base. And here is a closer look to the last card for today. So now let's take a quick look on all the 10 cards that I have created today using the December Card Kit by Simon Says Stamp. And these were the cards for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more videos where I am creating 10 cards out of previous card kits by Simon Says Stamp. Thank you all for watching.